my son, Miss Davis.
Gazing dreamily at the screen, waiting for the internet to connect. Anticipation rising for what was new to be seen. A friend base of 1,000 will show go soon, I detect.
Finally! Oh wow! Several contacts are now on Facebook.
My inbox is filled with messages and updates.
But first, I must check what Pixel has been posting.
Wait! Stop! Is that?
No!
She wouldn't post a nude picture.
Inspecting further, that's just the head on someone's naked body.
Disgusting! There's even a sex video.
Why am I tagged in it?
I'll scroll down and do something else.
But the messages are even worse and they've even gone viral.
How is she going to look in school?
Who would do such a thing to someone else?
I could not perceive the nasty comments that were made. How did meaning the whole thing make her look? The ghostly look on her face as she watched her classmates whisper and laugh at her in humiliation. Some pointed at her in mockery and others said the true words.
Nasty,
dumb,
stupid girl.
The comments replay in my mind. She's fat, ugly, nasty, dumb, a stupid girl.
I wish it would stop.
But the matter just exasperated as the days passed by. OMG, and her reputation is destroyed.
Bullies hide behind keyboards. Think before you type.
Thank you very much.
Secondary school youth symposium, having a wonderful time. Schools are just finishing doing their presentation. I must say the topic is on cyberbullying. You know, trying to reach out to see how we can stop cyberbullying in the high schools and stuff. So it's very interesting and we're having a wonderful time. 2017 at the secondary school youth symposium.
Every day from 8 to 1, we see happening different forms. At Guru Secondary School, the older students take advantage of the younger ones. WhatsApp messages and embarrassing bits are sent to hurt each other, while rumors are spread to bring down one another.
Students don't sit there while others are getting bullied.
But what can be done to minimize cyberbullying and violence at GSS now?
Well, students, take action.
Protest.
Go to safe spaces.
And report.
Let's start to make a change. Cyberbullying is present at your school.
Drove to a secluded bush area somewhere before Douglas. He took off all my clothes and his pants right away and started to penetrate me.
Wow.
After he tried for a while, he told me to open my mouth wide and he put his then started to move. He had to stop when I started to vomit, but that did not stop him. I went through that two more times within a few months by the same man. One time at 14, my older brother, and at one time at 15, by the man my mom is married to right now. Imagine, she married him right after he raped me. Only God knows the way I feel each time I see my mom's husband and her son. The pain, it never goes away. I can't stop asking why. Why me? But I guess there's nothing I can do to change what happened in the past. I feel bound by these bad memories, even though I try and I try and I try to be free. These are only two stories, two of hundreds. Through the Lady Dominic movement, we received over 300 plus stories, most of these stories by women, a few by men, about five or six of them by men. And this was a very overwhelming experience for my team. Miss Key and Bastian were the first story, the member of the task force as well. And so the stories we read are not about us, it's the story that we received. And we launched this movement last year in November for the 16 days of activism against gender-based violence. And as a result of that, we were able to capture the emotions and feelings of a number of women and people, generally speaking, as it relates to sexual offenses and the fact that they were harboring those secrets for a number of years. We use an anonymous technique to collect the stories through Facebook, through our emails, through WhatsApp as well. And this is really and truly the power of social media.
There's the situations that you face and be able to also advocate for others. So we are very proud of this school. I mean, you have did an awesome job.
So it has been an awesome student council forum. I'm so excited for the results. We had about 10 schools representing 10 secondary schools, and they all made presentations. Well, actually, some of them made presentations on the reality of violence at their school, and they also came up with ways in which we as students are going to address these issues, and we as NGOs are going to support them in that. So we are super excited about it.
All right, thanks.
School-based violence and bullying is not a very good thing. And so this activity was held, to sensitize to students, you know, and to, of course, get them to realize that they need to fight against the whole idea, you know, of bullying other students and fighting in school and so on, you know. So I think that was your idea.
Today was an eye-opener, for us at the Casper Secondary School. We definitely are geared and highly motivated to combat bullying, violence of any form, especially concerning our youth. Thank you to everyone who invited us here today. Thank you to Ms. Valerie Honoré.
I think the event was very educational for me. I realized that I was a supporter of cyberbullying, and I now realize how it might affect my peers. So my urge to everybody else, if you know that you are cyberbullied, then stop.
The best thing to do is bully someone, because we don't like someone to do it to you. Please, talk to someone that you know if someone is bullying you.